Welcome to our Palm Sunday meditation. As we look forward to this Holy Week, to the good news of our salvation, and to Easter, which is the hope of all our well-being in the resurrection of Jesus, I invite you now to share with me the call to worship for this day. Jesus went toward Jerusalem ahead of his disciples. As they came to the towns of Bethphage and Bethany on the Mount of Olives, he sent two disciples ahead. Go into that village, he told them, and as you enter in, you will see a colt tied there that has never been ridden. Untie it and bring it here. If anyone asks you what you're doing, just say, the Lord needs it. So they brought the colt to Jesus and threw their garments over it for him to ride on. Then the crowds spread out their coats on the ground ahead of Jesus. All began to shout and sing, praising God for all the wonderful miracles they had seen, saying, bless the King who comes in the name of the Lord. Peace in earth and glory in the highest heavens. Indeed, peace in earth and glory to the highest heavens. Amen. From Luke's Gospel, chapter 19. This day, as we gather for this Palm Sunday, I hope you've received your palms from us in a letter. But the palms symbolize a welcome, a sense of peace, a sense of hope, a sense of well-being. And that is all summed up in a single Hebrew word, shalom. Shalom. Welcome to our time of sharing. Well-being in your journey this Holy Week. Peace of body, mind, and spirit be with you. I invite you to share that word with one another and with God. Shalom in Christ. Shalom. And as we gather this day, I invite you to share our prayer preparation for our time together. Let us pray. Father God, we lift our hands up, we lower our heads, and we fall on our knees. Only you will hear the cries of your children. Only the shepherd knows his sheep. Direct us on the right path. Deliver us from the evil that surrounds us. Order our steps. Help us to be better friends, better companions, better neighbors, better co-workers, better life partners, better caretakers, better healers, better family, better Christians, more like thee. Give us wisdom and understanding. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Indeed, this Palm Sunday, in Jesus' name we pray, amen. The scripture lesson today is from the letter of Paul to the Romans, the 5th chapter. Paul writes this, therefore, since we are justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have obtained access to this grace in which we stand. And we boast in our hope of sharing the glory of God. And not only that, but we also boast in our sufferings, knowing that suffering produces endurance, and endurance produces character, and character produces hope. And hope does not disappoint us, because God's love has been poured out into our hearts through the Holy Spirit that has been given to us. Today is Palm Sunday, the entry of Jesus into Jerusalem to observe the Passover. As I have said, a symbol of hope, assurance, and liberation. And in the Gospels, it mentions that these palms were spread out before him to welcome him. That first Palm Sunday, was an expectation the people gathered of hope. In the last couple of weeks, I've been talking about the three H's. One is help. Seeking God's help, especially in this time of crisis in which we are passing through. Healing in this time of crisis, not only of body, but of mind and spirit, as we expect refreshment, renewal, and revival. Hope is a source of the story of Easter. And I look at the word hope this way. The letter H for hope is about honesty. To be honest about our situation that we find ourselves in. Not in a fantasy world, but in the real world. What is going on and how we can deal with it appropriately. O, opportunity. What is before us that we can do? What is before us that we can share together? What is before us that we can rejoice in? In our faith, the one rejoicing is the opportunity to celebrate Easter. The opportunity to express again, I have seen the Lord. He is alive. He is risen for us. The P is for possibilities. What is really possible that we can do? We still can worship together, even though we're apart. That's a possibility. Part of possibility is reality, that we will pass through this time together of concern and need and unfortunately loss. And then the E is for experience, the experience of God's presence with us. That no matter what happens, we experience that presence, that hope, that healing. Notice what Paul said, that hope is a source of many blessings, even in suffering and sorrow. Again, we are going through a terrible time. There have been losses due to this illness that surrounds us. But our hope has opportunity for us to praise God, possibilities for us going forward, and the experience that we are God's children and that God does not leave us but is always with us to guide us and lift us up. And very simply, the good news of Easter is that Jesus is alive for us this day. And that hope is not only for our body and its healing. Hope is not only for our mind and its understanding. Hope is not only for the spirit within us to have our sense of being. Hope is for us, each of us, through God's grace in Jesus. And that again we can rejoice and say, this coming Easter Sunday, I have seen the Lord. He is alive with me and with me and guides me this day and every day. May God bless you this day. May you pass through this coming Holy Week with peace of mind, peace of body, and peace of spirit. May you go through this Holy Week with assurance of the hope of God with us and with the love of Christ within us and the faith that knows no bounds. God bless you and keep you this day and every day. Amen. As we gather now for the prayer for this day, I invite you to offer up your prayers to God and Christ, that in your prayers, pray for the healing of this nation, for wisdom and guidance for those who govern this nation, and for friends and neighbors who may be affected by this virus, to pray for family, loved ones, that God keep you healthy, safe, and secure. Let us pray. Gracious God, our God, you who have lovingly created each of us in your image. We come to you this day for solace and comfort, for help, healing, and hope. Give us the grace to experience the faith that we share with one another in this coming week as we journey towards Easter. Jesus, we call upon you to walk with us, not only as our Savior and Lord, but as our friend, whose arm is around us to hold us and to help us, and if need be, to carry us over whatever may befall. And Holy Spirit, we ask that your word come to us and help us to know that you are there to give us power, strength, and courage to face the days ahead. And to let us know that the light shines in the darkness of this moment. Darkness can never put it out, and that light shines for us. We ask that light to shine this day, and this week, and this month, for this nation, for those who lead this nation, that they lead with wisdom, and courage, and character. We pray this day for those who have been infected by this terrible virus, that they shall be able to pass over the effects of it. We pray this day for families who have lost loved ones. We offer our prayers of condolence and caring. And we pray for each other, O Lord, to you, to be our strength, our presence, our help, our healing, and indeed our hope. This day and every day, through Jesus Christ, who is the way, the truth, and the life for each of us, and who taught us to pray these words of prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. As we come to a close of our time together, I thank you for being with me. I thank you for your personal prayers and concerns. And I invite you to give a call to friend and neighbor, parishioner, to check in on them and how they're doing. Be well and stay well, and we shall gather again, if not in person, but in spirit, as we celebrate the good news of Easter. I have seen the Lord, who has been our help, our healing, and our hope. Amen. And as we close this day's meditation, please join me in sharing the words of this great hymn. Blessed be the ties that binds our hearts in Christian love. The fellowship of kindred hearts is like to that above. Go in peace, and may the God of peace go with you this day and every day until we meet again. Amen.